Hi, in this video, we will see how to audit your content for entities using the audits feature inside of Inlinks. So for this video, I have taken in an article belonging to DixonJones.com, who is the CEO of Inlinks. So I will access this article that I have added into this Inlinks project, and I will audit this page for its targeted keyword. So the article itself is this one, how to migrate your Twitter handle. And then we are going to click on audits here. And the keyword that I'd like to use is how to migrate Twitter handle. Indicate the keyword here. How to migrate a Twitter handle, and then click on OK. Now the Inlinks NLP algorithm is analyzing the top 10 pages that rank the best on Google for this keyword, how to migrate a Twitter handle, and it's recognizing their most prominent topics, and at the same time comparing these topics with the entities that are being found in this article, so as to give a gap analysis in order to say, here are the topics we have been using compared to the competing pages, and here are the topics we're missing on. So essentially the idea would be to update our content with respect to the missing entities. Okay, so once the audit is ready within of the Inlinks content editor here, the first thing to check is the estimated SEO score, which is shown on this part of the tool. As we can see right now, the estimated SEO score of 45%. And the idea would be to increase our SEO score here to 80% and above while updating our content here and on this content editor, and still using the topics that are shown here as not used. At the same time, I can see that we have been using some of the topics that are also found in the competing pages, such as Twitter, user, accounting, website, but we're missing on topics such as here Facebook, user profile, social media, click analytics, and so on. I can filter these topics by displaying only the missing ones found in the competing pages by clicking here on missing topics. So I can instantly see what are the missing entities I can use on my content editor here. So for instance, if I wanted to increase the SEO score here from 45% and above, I would perhaps start using the term user profile. I can use this somewhere here, just randomly, just to show you user profile. And then we will see that this topic has been detected as okay here under the topics analysis, and also the estimated SEO score will improve. So the idea here would be to update the content naturally, still using these topics that are shown here under the topics analysis part. We also do have some further topics that we can, or further features that we can use in the same part of the tool. So we have some of the related keywords we can use. For instance, regarding Twitter, I can see some of the related keywords I can use in my content. So I can use a Twitter account or Twitter sign, and whenever I click on I select these related keywords, I will find them here all the way down in the content ideas of the content editor. We also do have a question finder that we can use as a starting point for new paragraphs. So for example, I can use some of the questions related to hashtag or maybe Twitter in itself. So I can click some of the questions that are found in the competing content. So clicking on Twitter here, I can start using some of the questions here that do make sense with respect to the context of my article. So I can use a question such as how Twitter account is verified, maybe why Twitter account is suspended, and whenever I select the ones that I'd like to use in my content, I will also find them here under the content ideas. Further to that, when we click on this down arrow here, we will expand the audits and go back to the topics analysis part. The tool will display the SEO score of our content inside of the content editor, alongside some key recommendations. So first, some recommendations regarding the number of words we should have compared to the competing pages. And here at glance, the most important topics to include. Scrolling down, we can see the same list of topics as we have seen under the topics analysis. And so we can see here the ones that are marked in green have been used by our content, and the ones that are marked in blue are the missing ones. And also this list of topics is ranked by order of importance. So we have this importance column, which shows the what are the most important topics based on this bar, which is full for the first few topics here, as opposed to all the other ones that are at the bottom of the list, which are less important to cover. Further to this, we can also check the topic chart, which is a visual representation of the topics analysis part. So in this part of the tool, we can see a graph which displays the missing topics here, shown by importance according to a color code. So for instance, the ones that are shown in red are the important topics to include, and these can be found in the outer circle of this graph. And so once we have a satisfactory SEO score here, we can go back to our on the live article itself, update the content with what we have done here on in the content editor. And once the content is audited on the live website, we should go back here and then click here on update and then update live URL. Then the tool will display what is the actual live URL of the live article. So I just would like to note that you can share the access to an audit inside of your Inlinks project to an external writer by using this icon here. So say for instance you'd like to give access to a writer so he can start updating the content within of Inlinks. You can click off here, click on here, add a new writer here. And then once you have added a new writer as a user within your account, you can assign this audit to your writer, indicate a due date, add some comments, and then click on submit. Then your writer will have access to your audit and start updating your content. So this is a video about how to audit your content on Inlinks. I hope that this was useful. If you need any help with respect to how to audit your content for entities on Inlinks, please do reach out to us on the chat window here. Thank you very much for your attention, and I hope to see you very soon.